Hello friends, in the last video, I told you how you can install local WordPress on Windows PC. Now in this video, I will tell you how you can install and set up WordPress on an Android phone so that you can start learning WordPress even though you don't have a desktop. To install WordPress on Android, you are going to need an application named KSWEB. So open your Play Store and then search for KSWEB. See KSWEB, search for it. This is the application that you need to install, KSWEB. Web developer kit. This application offers free trial for 7 days and after that you need to purchase pro version to keep using it. Anyway, I believe in you guys, you will find pro version of this application somehow, or if you wanna purchase it, you can purchase the pro version. Now let's open our KSWEB application. If you will open first time, this is how it will look. First it will ask for permission to access files and folders, and then it will install everything that is required. And after that, from Apache section, you can turn on your Apache server. See? Turn it on and then make sure PHP and MySQL is turned on. It is turned on by default. Now from tool section, click on PHP MyAdmin and then select Apache. This will download PHP MyAdmin. It will take some time. It is of approx 16 MB, and after it is downloaded, it will be unzipped as you can see on the screen. And then KSWEB will add a new host for the selected server as you can see here. Now just click on OK. We will come back to this later. And now let's download WordPress zip file. Minimize this application KSWEB. See, everything is on right now. So minimize it and now open your browser. I will open my DuckDuckGo browser. DuckDuckGo. And here what you have to do is to just search download WordPress to download the WordPress zip file. Click on the first result, that is from wordpress.org. See this one. Click on it. Right now my internet is slow, that's why it's taking time to load. Say this is the WordPress site. Here what you have to do is to keep scrolling down and then click on download WordPress 5.8.2 to download a zip file of the WordPress. DuckDuckGo browser does not support downloading, that's why it's asking me to use some external app like ADM or ES downloader. But I have already downloaded the WordPress file, so I won't have to download it again. See, in ES file explorer, if I will go to internal and ADM, this is the WordPress zip file that I have downloaded. So after you download zip file, what you have to do is to select it and then extract it to htdocs folder. After you install KSWEB, a htdocs folder will be created in your internal storage. See where it is? See here. Just extract WordPress file here in this htdocs folder and you are done. Now we can go back to KSWEB application. So let me close this and then back to KSWEB. In KSWEB, we have already enabled everything, so everything is running. Here in Apache section, click on the host one, that is localhost is to 8080. And then open it in any browser. See, this page is hosted by KSWEB on localhost is to 8080. Here you can find your SQL login data. See, login is root and password is empty. So from here you can find your SQL login data, that is usually root and the password is empty. Now to open your PHP MyAdmin, click on the host 0, that is 8001. In my case, PHP MyAdmin is hosted on localhost is to 8001 port. It may be different in your case if something is already on 8001 port. Here, what you have to do is to type username as root and then password login. So it does not matter where it is hosted, just find the address from KSWEB. And here, after you log in into PHP MyAdmin, see, you need to create one database for your WordPress website. So for that, click on this three line and then click on database. Here, enter the name of your database. See here, I will create a database named WordPress since we are hosting a WordPress site, and then click on create. It is created. Now we can go back and check it. Click on three line and then databases. And here we see WordPress new database. Everything is completed now. We have extracted WordPress zip file in htdocs folder, created a database for our WordPress site. Now let's start installing WordPress. So for that, type localhost is to 8080/WordPress. Since the extracted folder name was WordPress, that's why I'm typing WordPress. If you change it to something else, type that name here. And then the WordPress installation will begin. Select your language and then click on continue. And then click on let's go to connect it with our database. Database name is WordPress, leave it as it is. Username for our database is root, R-O-O-T. And the password is blank, leave it as it is. And then just click on submit button. Now that we have connected it to our database, let's run the installation. On this page, you need to provide basic details for your WordPress site, like your site title. I will name it as WordPress, and then the username. I will enter admin as username, and the password will be same since we are installing this in our local server. Admin, and then confirm to use weak password, and then type any email, for example admin@admin.com, and then click on install WordPress to complete the installation process. See, install WordPress. I click 2 times, so maybe it will say that it is already installed. See, already installed. Now click on login to login into your WordPress site. This is the login page for your WordPress site, and the address for this login page is wordpress/wp-login.php. Let me show you. See, wp-login.php, and here what you have to do is to type admin and admin. Enter. In my case it is admin and admin. In your case, if you have specified another password and username, type it there. And here is our WordPress site. Say, welcome to WordPress. You can do all the things that we do in WordPress, like installing a theme or a plugin. So let's try to install a theme. No, let's try first plugin. So click on add new to add a new plugin. And here let's install this classic editor. I will click on install now, and it is installing, as you can see. It will take time. It needs to download it and then install it in our local server. See, it is installed. Now if I will click on activate, it will be activated. See, it is activated now. Classic editor activated. Now let's try to install a theme. Click on appearance and then themes. Here click on add new. See, add new button. Click on it. And then search for any theme that you want, like Astra. See, it is taking time. This is the Astra theme, but this is not searched. It should come on first. See, this is Astra. My internet is slow a little bit, and I am sorry for that. So by clicking on any theme, you can simply install it in the same way we installed plugin. So this is how you can install and use WordPress in your Android device locally to learn WordPress or to create WordPress sites. I hope you have found this video useful. If yes, don't forget to like this video. I will see you in next.